Another day, another update, and today it's all about the zinc alloy cases. So we're now at the die casting factory, and at the die casting factory we're going to look at the die casting, the CNC process and polishing, and afterwards we're going to go to the painting, and finally we're going to go to the assembly line to see the zinc alloy case to be assembled. Very exciting day today, let's get started. Here we are at the die casting machine. This huge machine is what makes your zinc alloy case. So what happens is, over there you see a big pot of zinc. I have raw material right next to it. These are zinc ingots that go into that pot. It melts it down to a liquid. You can see the robot arm is now picking out with a bucket the liquid, and then it's gonna put that into the feeder. Then it goes just like the plastic injection. It will go into a spout, which pushes it into that mold. And that mold comes together, right? The female male mold come together. The spout injects that liquid. It saturates the cavity inside that mold. Then you have the whole piece there. It separates again. You have a robot arm coming in, taking out the case, and then bringing it over to what we can see on this side, the conveyor belt. On the conveyor belt, it goes through a cooling process because it's really hot. While it's going through the cooling process on the conveyor belt, the mold, you can see over there, has these really big rods attached to an arm, and that is to cool down the mold before it does the next injection, because it gets really, really hot. So once it's on the conveyor belt, it goes to this ending part, and you can see, hold on, what's happening to this top case? There's so much material around the top case. Why is that the case? Well, it helps with the injection flow, having that entry point and then having those other points to make sure the injection as well. But we don't need that excess material around that top case. So that's what we have this one for. This machine stamps away all that excess material. And once that excess material is stamped away, you have only the top case left. But it's not complete just yet, because on the top case, there's still a lot of these big pieces attached to it, big burrs attached to it. And that is removed in the next step, which is the CNC machine. But before we go there, let me show you also the new green mean machine that they've purchased recently. This green mean big machine is a 500 ton die casting machine. It's a new one on which our bottom cases are gonna run on. This is twice the amount of the ones we just saw, which is 250 tons. Now this ton amount is very important because it's about the pressure of the female male mold being pushed together. And the better it's pushed together and kept close and tight, the better the tolerances are and the more precise and less defect rates there are. So this is going to be pretty exciting, because that's new developments that happen within the factory, thinking proactively, how can we make a better product, get the defect rate down, and get better cost pricing. So this is exciting. Now let's head over to the CNC machine to see what happens there. So here we are at the CNC machine. Now the CNC machine is basically a really big drill that can drill into the material. It can do it from different axes, from the top, side, all around. It depends on the machine and the jigs that are inside. These machines can do all axes, but they still divided the process now in two steps. There's one that goes from the top and there's one that goes from the side. Now the first step from the top is the important one, to get away those burrs that we saw before. So here, you have the case that just came out of that die cast mold. You can see those big pieces, those big chunks pointing, sticking out. So that's gonna be removed from the top side, but it's also gonna grab a different drill to drill in some extra holes, like for the daughter board and also for the silicone feet holes. So after that finishes, as you can see here, we have our holes also for the daughter board, and all those big burrs are all gone. But the second step over here, focus on that on the side, because there needs to be a USB hole. It doesn't have it yet. After this one, it adds the USB hole from the side, and also it makes sure that there's a hook area for our top case also from the side. So here you can see now it has that USB-C hole. Now that this is all completed, it can go over to the polishing area, where I can do this final process before it goes to painting. So let's go take a look at the polishing area. And here we are at the polishing area. You can see behind me, they're polishing the top case. Now what happens with the polishing is that after the CNC, there are still a lot of burrs around the areas here. And on the top, there could still be some cavities or holes or imperfections. So what happens, they grab the top case, you put it in a jig that's completely flat, and then you use a polishing machine to flatten out the whole surface. Now this is the most important surface because that's the customer facing surface. So we want to make that as good as possible. Then the ladies next to him are polishing with a sponge on the sides to get away little jagged burrs that you can't really see, but you can feel it. Then they'll also double check on the bottom if there's any other little burrs or something to polish that away as well. So when that is done, you get a finished version. And this finished version is full scratches, but you can feel that it's completely smooth here. And it's all ready now to go to the next process, which is painting. So let's head there right now. And here we are at the painting factory. This is a very short process that I'm gonna walk you through. It all starts with the die casting we had before, and then it comes into this factory for the black painting, or actually to be very exact, it's a nano electro painting method. It's actually a very recent method that they've perfected over the last year, and now we're using that for your HHE black case. So it starts here where they hang all the top plates and the bottom cases onto hooks. You can see behind me the big reel where it's going to bring that all automatically to the bath area. And the bath area, that is a part that's very important, because first the bath area, it goes into this pre-cleaning process, and this pre-cleaning process is very important to make the whole surface free from oil, free from fats, and ready for that painting process. That painting process happens right after the cleaning automatically, and once it's painted, it goes into the ovens. And the ovens, those take hours to complete before it comes out of the oven, and then it has a final inspection, and then it's ready and will go to the assembly area. Here behind me, you can see all the baths. These are the smaller ones, there are big ones over there. How about we go back to the assembly factory and see how that case is then put together. And now we have the white zinc case being assembled on the assembly line. And you might recognize this because we had a video recording on day two as well, when we went through the whole assembly line and every step of the assembly line. I recommend you to watch that video if you want to see what happens exactly with every step, because with the zinc alloy case, it's pretty much the same. There's just a few key differences, and we're going to go through those few key differences. So let's jump into the first key difference, which is the pour-on foam on the bottom case of the zinc alloy. So here we have three. Operate. Oh, they're doing the black one now. Here we have three operators basically sticking on pour-on foam, seven pieces. On each side we have pour-on foam, and we put it there to prevent the metal to metal contact each other directly, so it prevents also ringing throughout the case. That is one difference. The second difference is the screwing from the bottom case to the top plate. Instead of that happening automated by a machine, it's done manually, and it's done for a couple of reasons. First and foremost is to prevent any kind of scratch on the bottom case. If an automated machine would make a mistake and scratch anything, the whole bottom case is defect. And what happens then? Well, can you still use it? You can't, because you just can't repaint it. So that's why they do it manually. In this case, maybe it's going to change in the future, we don't know yet, but that's what's happening manually right now. Then the next difference is that we have our visual inspection here. Because they've just been doing all this assembling of a white case, and you know how sensitive white is to dirt, marks, and blemish. So here they do a visual inspection with a final clean to make sure there's no blemish or no dirt or marks left on the case. Then, hey, you see here that automatic visual inspection of the keycap stuff, it's all the same. And here we get into the final difference, which is the packaging. So we have the assembled boxes here. You can see them actually assembling boxes here as well. But then here we have the travel case. So every zinc alloy keyboard comes in a travel case. And now they're putting first the accessories into the travel case. Then they put the zinc alloy keyboard into the travel case. That goes into its final box. And then it goes into the master carton, following the same steps. And that is pretty much how the zinc alloy case gets made from the beginning all the way to the assembly here in the end. I hope you enjoyed today. Tomorrow is the final day where we're going to look a bit on the keycaps and a few other things on manufacturing. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.